privilege to open with a word of prayer.
Thank you, Lord, for those that stand here today.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray this day. Amen.
Amen.
Welcome to In a Moment with Pastor Jay Klein, talking about walking in this world as Christ-filled believers endeavoring to stand on His promises. And now here's Jay.
Welcome to another episode of In a Moment. As the announcer said, my name is Jay Klein. Glad to have you here today. You know, one of the beauties of knowing God and His Bible is realizing that His promises are always faithful and His promises are always true in good times and in bad. And isn't it such, in all I know in my life, I suspect in yours as well, the most of the times it's in the bad that we recognize God, or in the time of pain we recognize our Lord. I don't know, I suspect you are, as I am, in that same category. I would like to first off say today that we're going to be doing a live show today. So when you finish hearing this teaching later on today, please call in. Let me know your thoughts on the teaching. Let me know what God has done for you. This is Tuesday, so we are going to do our Tuesday two-minute testimonies. Give me a call. Let me know what God has done for you in your life. Give us a call at locally at 518-237-1330. And outside of the calling district, capital district here, it'll be 1-800-520-8692. But back to my topic on how God's promises never fail us. He tells us that He comforts us in our time of need, and He's always with us, and that He will never leave us. I'm sure you've experienced that in your life. I really want to hear how God has worked in your life this week, today, 20 minutes ago. You know, the value of having a relationship with God is that we can enjoy a relationship like you would do with your mother or your father. I can tell you that in time of sorrow, He is our refuge. In time of need, He is our all and all. He promises us this, and He surely walks the walk, and God talks the talk. God walks the walk, and He talks the talk. And we're to do the same. You know, the Bible tells us that we are as He is, talking of His Son Jesus, our Lord, our Savior. We are as He is in Christ, because we have Christ living right now inside of us. You know, the beauty of God's healing presence is that, I'll give you one quick example. My mother, God bless her, she passed away last week, and it was a very hard time of sorrow and mourning, but the sorrow wasn't nearly what it would be had I not known in my heart that she is, as the Scripture says, asleep in the Lord, and that as the Scriptures teach us, when our Lord returns, the dead in Christ rise first. What great comfort. It tells us at the end of that section in Thessalonians, wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Boy, oh boy, if that doesn't lead directly into this wonderful topic I want to share on today called Why Stay Faithful. You know, there's a real reason to stay faithful. I realize that, you know, you can go to a lot of churches, and God bless these churches, and I thank God for the men and women who participate in the churches serving God's people. I thank God for their lives. And I am convinced with all of my heart that as long as we stay faithful to the Scriptures, as the Scriptures teach us, then we too have the opportunity to say that sorrow is not sorrow when we have the comfort of the Lord and His return. When we come back from this message, we'll get into our teaching.
Have you ever thought what political party or issues Jesus would identify with? Many people believe that the Christian faith has become more about political agendas and less about connecting with God. Have you experienced a situation where you needed understanding, love, or forgiveness, and you didn't find it? That's exactly why Jesus came. We want to help you experience His love and forgiveness. If you're interested in learning what it means to have Jesus in your life, call 888-NEED-HIM or go to chataboutjesus.com.
Welcome and God bless you to another episode of In a Moment. My name is Jay Klein, and today I would like to share a little bit about a topic that I think is kind of possibly misunderstood or possibly never really considered, because we oftentimes grow up in a message that might be one way, and then as we grow in the Word and study and research and live life 10, 20, 30, 40 years later, you continue to grow in the scriptures and learn more about the scriptures. And today I would like to share some things I have also had the privilege to see and know and recognize to be not exactly as it was possibly when I originally believed God's word. It only embellished it and made it even nicer and bigger and stronger and more wonderful to know. So I thought I'd share some of these words with you today. First off, I would like to start in 1 John chapter 5, verse 5. It's the verse that says, "Who is he that overcometh the world, but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God?" That verse is the theme from the beginning to the end of this sharing. I want you to keep that verse in your mind, because truly these words I want to share with you possibly might be different than what you have heard in the past or to consider in the past. You would have had a hard time. First off, let me preface it by saying, in the beginning, God said to Eve and Adam, "Thou shalt surely die the day thou eat thereof." And our adversary, the devil, introduced in chapter 3, verse 1 of Genesis, he ultimately said to Eve, "Thou shalt not surely die." And I would like to suggest that the premises of my sharing today is based truthfully on those two kinds, on those two words. When God's saying, "Thou shalt surely die the day you eat thereof," and the devil saying, "Thou shalt not surely die," is the difference between being obedient and not being obedient. And I have to believe in my heart, from the scriptures I see, that theme carries out throughout all of the scriptures. And from that, I would like to continue. I would like to start in the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 21. These are Jesus' words. "Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall inherit the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven." I highlighted a couple of words in that verse, and the words I highlighted were, "but he that doeth the will of my Father." Jesus says that not everyone that has said to me, "Lord, Lord," shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. Well, that's kind of a contradictory statement to what I've always understood in the past. But Jesus says, "Thou shalt not everyone shall inherit the kingdom of heaven." But, it says, "but he that doeth the will of my Father." But he that doeth, but he that is doing, but he that doeth. It doesn't say, "but he who did the will of my Father." It says, "but he who doeth the will of my Father." James chapter 2, and in verse 20, it says, "but wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead." Not that you have to work your way to the kingdom. You can't. Christ took care of that for us. He made that salvation available to mankind. In 1 Timothy chapter 4 and in verse 16, it says, "Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee." It says here, take heed. What is it to take heed to something? Hold on to it. Don't let it go. For in doing this, for in doing what? For in continuing in them, for in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. If you continue in them, thou shalt both save thyself and those who hear you. These are God's holy words as well. I know they're different. It brings a different understanding of the need to stay faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ. That's my concern. If you're a believer in Christ, listen to the message. I hope you learn from the message so maybe you can help somebody else out. But the reality of it is, if you believe in Christ, you're kingdom bound. You're set. You're good to go. But this is for those who had once believed and have choosing not to any longer. Hebrews chapter 3 verse 14 says, "For we are made partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast until the end.
we're made partakers. We are made partakers of Christ if we hold. We like to read certain words in the scripture and not concern ourselves too much with the other ones. In Colossians chapter 1, verses 22 through 23a, it says this, "And you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled in his body and his flesh through death to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight if you continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel." We oftentimes love to hear the message, as I did so many years past, that God, that Jesus is presenting me holy and unblameable and unreprovable, but never really took heed to the continuing in the context it was reading. It says here, he wants us to be presented holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. But it's if you continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel. Well, then what am I saying? Well, I'm just simply saying that this is what God's word is telling us, not to be moved. This is what God's word is telling us about holding on to. That this is what God's word is saying when he says, "But he that doeth the will of my Father." Jesus tells us to do the will of his Father. In the gospel, in the epistles, it says that faith without works is dead. In Timothy, he tells us to continue in doing these, so that in doing these actions, these works, thou shalt both save thyself and them who hear thee. Now, those are kind of different words than I had once known in my life. But here's a very interesting verse as well that I'd like for you to just consider these words specifically for those who have fallen away, who no longer follow after the Lord. As I mentioned, those of us who are believers, this message is simply, you know, for us to learn and to know about, to understand the importance of staying faithful. But I would like to share Galatians chapter 6, verse 8. It says, "For he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit of the Spirit shall reap everlasting life. And let us not be weary in well-doing." Don't be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Now, isn't it interesting? It tells us time and time again, if you continue in faith in Colossians, if you faint not in Galatians, throughout the gospel message. Now here we're hearing God's word say that he that soweth to the Spirit, how is it that if I am to sow to the Spirit, and once I said the name Jesus in my life, once I may have spoken in tongues, now I'm saved and nothing can happen. I can live a life of hell and everything's just fine. I'm still going to see the kingdom of God. But then why would it say in Galatians chapter 6, verse 8, "But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap everlasting life"? Why is there a need to sow to the Spirit to reap everlasting life if everlasting life was given once for all forever one time? Well, what was given once for all forever one time was the way of salvation that Jesus has made available. For those of us who believe on our Lord Jesus, we know we have everlasting life staring us in the face, praise God. We understand the greatness of this hope of his return. But like the devil did to Eve, she beguiled Eve. She told Eve, "Thou shalt not surely die. Thou shalt be like gods." This is what the adversary told to Eve. I would suggest today that nothing is new under the sun. And this adversary that we don't even really recognize too much anymore in our lives, we don't consider it very much anymore in our lives, has not changed one iota. For those who fall away from the Lord, what does the scriptures tell us in John 10:10? The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I would suggest that that Christian who followed the Lord and fell away, like it tells us in the parables of the good seed, how the seed was there, the seed fell, and pleasures and pressures and things of the world swallowed it up. I would suggest that it is to stay faithful. Our Lord Jesus Christ truly came once for all, forever, for mankind to make salvation available. But truly take heed, as it tells us here in these wonderful scriptures we've been reading. Please take heed to understand the importance of staying faithful. Time and time again, we've read scriptures tonight showing the need to stay faithful. Ask God for discernment today. Ask God to show you. Ask God to help you consider His words that I just read for you here. I love you. Pray. Praise God. We're kingdom bound. We know that. The issue isn't are we, it's just stay faithful to the message. God bless you. I hope this has been a wonderful message. Have a great day.
Staying faithful. Wow, what a great topic. What a great understanding to realize that that's all the Lord asks us to do, is to stay faithful, walk in love, try to stand as He stands, and be along with Him at all times. You know, we are streaming live, as I mentioned here, at aliveradionetwork.com. So feel free to call in long distance at 800-520-8692 and locally at 237-1330. So I'm looking forward to your phone calls. Like to hear what your thoughts are on this wonderful topic. It gives us great comfort to know that the accuracy of God's Word is so simple. It's so wonderful to recognize what He will do for us. I mentioned in that teaching a little bit about how the adversary, the serpent in Genesis chapter 3, beguiled Eve. And I truly mean, I believe nothing is new under the sun. And that as the scriptures teach us that presently we are under the rulership of the darkness, of the ruler of the air, but there will come a day when that will all change. And I believe that though nothing is new under the sun, and that same influence is still out there telling us, oh, it's okay, do whatever you want, it's perfectly fine, do whatever you want, it's okay, no big deal. Of course, when God said, thou shalt surely die, and the serpent said, thou shalt not surely die, we certainly know what chaos then came upon our world today. Thus, all of the, you know, all the stuff we deal with in our lives without a godly center. And I can tell you that it's a blessing to know that our God is always with us and He's always faithful. So that's 237-1330 locally, 1-800-520-8692. Give me a call. Let me know what your thoughts are. Also, if you're just wanting to get a message out to people about your relationship with God and what He's done for you today or this week, please feel free to call in. This is a live show, and I look forward to your comments, all right? To go back to my show a moment ago of why stay faithful. You know, it does say in 1 John 5:5 in the Bible, New Testament, it says, who is he who overcomes the world? Well, isn't that a great question? Aren't people wanting to know that today? Who is he who overcomes the world? Have you learned that in your churches? I hope so. The message is stated here in 1 John 5:5, who is he who overcomes the world? But he who believes that Jesus is the Son of the living God. I'm hoping that those are the messages that you hear in your churches weekly. I know that I always try to encourage people to go back to your church, get involved in your church, listen to the minister, listen to the people, fellowship with like-minded believers in God's Word. So who is he who overcomes? And the overcoming is not necessarily in this world. We know that we have Christ in our life. We know that he supports us. We can ask him and he will take care and comfort us. We know this to be true because the scriptures teach us that that is true. But who is he who overcomes the world? Overcomes the world, I believe with all of my heart, is in relationship to those who have fallen asleep and the eternal life that is promised to us believers. Jesus Christ died on that cross so that we could have everlasting life. Simply says, stay faithful. You know, in Matthew 7:21, it says, Jesus talking here, he says, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven. Well, now, I'm hoping that we understand that. Jesus says here, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, should enter the kingdom of heaven. Well, then, if that be the case, and if that is true, which kind of isn't how I believed at one time in my life, but if that is true, what do we need to do? Well, if we continue on that same verse, it says, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father. The criteria is he who does the will of my Father. So it's important to understand that the will of our Father is what God wants us to be doing. That tells us who is he who overcomes, and that is he who does the will of my Father. These are simple truths of God's word. I'm sure your churches are sharing these messages with you, and I have great comfort in my heart knowing that this is God's rightly divided word. So it's important to recognize that God is always with us through his Son, Jesus Christ. So I believe we have a caller in. So we have Debbie on line one from Albany. Hello, Debbie. Are you there?
Hi, Jay. Good to talk to you.
Oh, hi. How are you?
Good, thank you. Great teaching today. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I just wanted to share to anyone who's listening that staying faithful is not a difficult thing. You know, the Lord wants us to be blessed. He's willing and able, you know, to intervene in our lives. We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, as the scriptures say. There is a spiritual battle going on with us every second of our lives. And you know, Jesus Christ said, you know, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. Mm. I think to someone who might be listening for the first time, you know, might get the impression that it's a difficult thing. You know, it's not such a difficult thing to stay faithful. You know, you just from personal experience, you know, you wake up in the morning, God, I give this day to you, you know, in the name of Jesus Christ. And it's a conscious effort for sure. It doesn't come easy. I mean, you have to work it, you know, like driving a car, you know, you have to drive your prayer. Gosh, it's just such a comfort to know. You know, for those of us who believe that the scriptures, all the scriptures are true, you know, not just hit and miss, but they're all true. It's such a comfort to know that it's the one thing in the world that we can rely on today.
Yeah.
You know, you can seek this self-help group, that self-help group, and, you know, they might be great, but they can only take you so far. You know, there's only one thing in the world today that you can positively stand on without the shadow of a doubt, and that's the Word. And I just wanted to thank you for what you shared today. It was awesome.
Well, thank you very much. It's these truths. I enjoy traveling every once in a while, and when I do so, it never ceases to amaze me that no matter where I go with Christians who are standing faithful for the Lord, it's the same message. And you have this camaraderie almost that even though you may not know the people at all, you have that kindred spirit that we are all those who are faithful to the Lord. We are all part of this body of Christ, and that he is always there to guide us and to lead us. And to your point, Debbie, I do really appreciate you bringing this up. This is not a difficult task. The difficult task was on the cross.
Yeah.
The difficult task was him giving his life for us. Now, once that is done, all we simply need to do is to confess him and to live for him. That truly is Christianity in a nutshell. And I'm very thankful.
I agree.
I'm very thankful for you calling in. So what did you think about, do you have anything that you want to share on how God's working in your heart?
Well, oh gosh, I don't know if we have enough time for that.
Well, we got a couple of minutes.
Oh, God has just been working great things, you know, in my life. Everything from, you know, my children, you know, I have two beautiful daughters, and, you know, they've the three of us have been through some rough times, you know, in our life, and, you know, being able to see them grow and seeing them heal and seeing them successful and happy, you know, that's the thing that's on my heart right at the very moment. Well, and I'm just so thankful for the other believers I have in my life. I have a real strong fellowship, and we have some great teachers in this area. We have great teachers, you know, locally and,
amen.
You know, around the world. And we have some great kids in this area, too. We have some very, very inspirational, phenomenal young people in this area. You know, the word is moving, and I'm thankful for that. And,
yeah, you know, I think that we either don't take it for granted. We either take it for granted or we don't know that we do. To your point, in the Capital District, we have some wonderful, wonderful teachers. And I'm thankful so much for the different churches that are around and that God is working in people's lives all the time. And it's a real blessing to recognize that. So, Debbie, I think I'm going to let you go right now, but we have another call. Thank you very much, Debbie, for calling in. And bless you. We'll talk to you soon.
God bless you. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. We have Raiden from Troy. Raiden, this is Jay Klein. Can I help you? Thank you for calling in.
Okay, Jay. Thank you. I'm not used to doing this kind of thing, but and my name is Rita, by the way.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you. Thank you,
but
Rita.
I just want to say I have just realized this afternoon that I am this week celebrating 40 years with the Lord. And I am just so thankful and so amazed for everything he has done, all the things that he's brought me through, and that the look back that he gave me when I first knew him, those kind of, if you want to call them visions in the night, it was like a series of vignettes showing me things from when I was a baby that I didn't have any memory of right up to the time at that time, and showing that he had been there all of my life.
Amen.
Before he revealed himself to me. He is such a wonderful, gracious God, and keeps those that he calls his own. I echo the previous caller's note. When she said the word faithfulness, that was what was on my mind. Hmm. It's his faithfulness to us first, and then our faithfulness. I looked up a verse in Scripture. I couldn't remember where it was, so I had to look in the concordance. I had to cheat now and then. But it's John 3:36, and it says basically the same thing. I don't really need a brighter light here unless you got it in your head by memory. But it is obedience.
Hmm. Yeah.
So, whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. Whoever does not obey the Son shall not see life.
Well, you know,
the wrath of God remains on him.
It says that also in another section of Scriptures in the first, I think it's in John 15, where Jesus says, you know, he who comes to me, I will pray my Father, and he will come unto you. And he who does not believe in me, neither will I pray to my Father for you. It's faithfulness is truly given to us by God. But it is truly, as you're saying, our responsibility to stay faithful. But why wouldn't we want to? You know.
Oh, please. And you know, so often, I mean, we go astray. How come? It's like Martin Luther, okay, who, you know, just needed to, you know, continually was aware of his sin, no matter how little they were.
Yep,
they knew
it
mattered. And then his freedom when he realized that it was by faith.
Amen. Amen. And you know who, you know, Abraham, the author of faith, the father of faith, and all those wonderful folks in the Hebrews that talks about how they walked with faith but yet have not yet received, how faith is such an important aspect of our lives. Well, we're very blessed to know that. I'm so thankful that you called in today. I really do mean that. This is a call-in show, and I really want the Capital District to hear all of our brothers and sisters, how God works in their life. And I'm so thankful for you doing this today. So I'm going to let you go now, but today's show is sponsored by Abiding Faith Ministries, Church in the Home out of Clifton Park. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
You've been listening to In a Moment with Pastor Jay Klein. If you would like any further information about today's show or Pastor Jay and his ministry, call 518-225-0705 or email jayklin1@aol.com. Thank you.
I will pray.